Hi everybody, welcome back to the channel. And we are a few days from the end of the competition running to win a copy of the Snafu game Equatorial Clash from Mark Figueres. If you look back a couple of episodes ago, I did an unbagging of this very unusual game covering a very neglected period of time during the Second World War. Started to get a few bits on the table and have a look at it myself. Very impressed. It's a great game. But have a look back at the video. Competition, very, very easy. Need to put something in the comments under that video linked to some names for a potential War Games room for myself. And I will pick the one I like the best. Probably in a couple of weeks' time, and announce the winner on the channel. So watch this space. But anyway, today I wanted to talk about Rebel Fury, the latest from the Mark Herman GMT Games stable. This is the Civil War Heritage Series Volume 1. I know there will probably already be lots and lots of videos out there on this long-awaited game following Mark's original Gettysburg small footprint game, and then he also did the Waterloo campaign. I've actually put my Gettysburg game inside this box. I've taken it out already, had a little look, but I just wanted to share with you, for those that haven't seen it yet, some of the components that you get in the game. And again, I may well do a video in due course once I've got it on the table. But the thing for me with this is you're getting a lot of bang for your buck with six battles in one box. So you're getting Fredericksburg and Chancellorsville, Chickamauga, Chattanooga, the Wilderness and Spotsylvania. Really great concept. Great price point, and I know Mark's already working on the next designs in the series, and I'm sure these are going to be high on a lot of people's purchase list as each one comes out. So I think Mark and GMT have definitely hit a winning formula with these games. But as always, you know, really nice artwork, GMT style box. On the back here, it just gives you a little bit of insight into what we'll see in the box shortly. But importantly here, you can see the design, map and counter art from Charlie Kibler, art director, game developer. And this is what we're going to get and have a look at in the box. So two player aids, two display cards, two 10-sided dice and a custom dice. One playbook, one rules manual, two counter sheets, three 22 by 34 inch game maps. I believe these are double-sided maps to allow you to play all the battles. I think it's double-sided. We shall have a look in a moment to confirm that. But that's what you get. So this game, as I say, I played when Gettysburg came out. Gettysburg I really like. I've played it a lot myself. It's a very quick small footprint game. Let's just pop these to one side a moment. So the Gettysburg came in C3I. It was a small footprint game with these are the original counters. Having bought a recent C3I issue with the new optional counters to play the game with the same style and art as Rebel Fury, I had to have those. But Gettysburg was great for what it was. It was a very fast playing little game, but with some very novel concepts. But we're not talking about that today. We're talking about Rebel Fury, which from my understanding has developed a lot more since that initial Gettysburg game and then the Waterloo campaign that came. So what do you get in the box? Well, as always with GMT, you get lots of baggies for all those counters. So that's great. Because you've got space in the box, I may well look to get a counter tray. We've got the dice, as we mentioned, nice blue and grey D10s, and an interesting looking custom dice there. So nice, good quality dice. We have rules of play in this sort of nice style that GMT use. This is a 24 page rule booklet. You can see sequence of play, attack resolutions on the back. You've got a really nice index. Love that in rules books. Keep that coming, please. So really you're talking about 20 pages of rules, and it's in the usual very nice, easy to read style. I love Mark Herman games. I think Mark has a really nice approach to gaming. I love the way he writes, and I love his examples of play, which are extensive in the book, to show you each part as you go through, so you can kind of understand it. You can set a few counters up and play it through, see what he did, and learn the game quite quickly. As you can see, there's quite extensive examples of play there, which I really like. So the actual rules themselves are a lot less than that 20 pages, because of those examples of play that we've spoken about there. Really nice rule book. Really nice rule book. We've then got the playbook, which covers the campaigns. And again, this is another 24 page booklet, the back of which is really the design notes, which I have already read and very interesting, around Mark's design theories and why he's done certain things with the games. And then we've got the setups for the various games in the box. Again, really nicely illustrated, good color palettes used. A few special rules with each one, but again, not too much. What again I like about this is you're not getting a base set of rules and then really another complete rules booklet for each battle like you do with some games. I find that very frustrating. I understand why people do it, but for me it just adds extra complexity, and I don't like that myself. So this is fine. There are some chrome special rules linked to each scenario, but the main rules cover everything you need to play. We've then got the various quick reference, so terrain effects on the back there. Again, really nicely done. Good card stock used, sequence of play, got everything you need on there, so I like that. You've got two of those. Okay, you then got the off map displays. So this is the Fredericksburg and Chancellorsville game map, the Union off map display on there, which is interesting. You've got the Rebel Fury remaining moves attacks, and then the various scenarios, the timing turn tracks. So from what I've seen online, you could potentially, because of the multiple maps and counters, you could have several games running, but you would probably need to just do multiple copies of this to be able to play that. But really nice idea with the game. So you could set up two, three games at the club and have them all going concurrently together. The counter sheets, good standard GMT card stock. You can see there from my thumb, they're decent sized counters. Really simple but nice artwork. Love the sort of units and how they're represented. You've got your commander's artillery, you've got your skirmishes, horse artillery, heavy artillery. Some really nice artwork, very clean and clear artwork. I think again on the table will be very easy to distinguish units and what they are. That's the front, and then on the back, again, even holding them away, you can still see them quite clearly. So really nicely done. We've got another sheet here with some more information on it. Again, you've got a lot of counters there, but of course these are all covering all six battles, so you're not going to have all of these on the table at once. And then we've got the maps, three good size maps. Let's just make some space to show you those. Okay, we're going to get the first one out, which is, and I am corrected, these are not double-sided. These are one map covering two battles. So that's the answer to that one. I'm sure everyone was screaming at the screen, no, you've got that wrong. It's not. It's one map covering two battles. I stand corrected. These maps are big. They're very big, in fact. And they're very beautiful. So I'm going to just zoom that out so you can see the size of that. You know, these are good size maps. And if we go the other way and we zoom in, what we should be able to do is get a real flavour of the quality of the artwork, which is beautiful. So you've got some really nice elements to here. I think this is the wilderness map, looking at the degree of wood and forest wilderness on the map there. So that's map number one. Let's just get out the other ones for you and let you have a look at those as well. So this is map number two, which is the Chickamauga Chattanooga map. Again, beautifully done. If we zoom in here, so you can again see there's a lot of woodland, difficult terrain. As anyone who knows about these battles will know, they played a significant part in the game. You've got various key elements. Chattanooga Creek there, the Chickamauga Creek, Pigeon's Roost Mountain. Very, very nice again. Really looking forward to getting these on the table. These are really, really good paper stock. They're that sort of glossy paper, quite hard wearing, as often is the case with GMT. I probably personally will put it under plexi just to protect the maps. But let's show you the third and final map. I would hazard a guess this is the Chancellorsville Fredericksburg map. Again, beautifully done. Again, lots of really nice details on there. We've got the Rappahannock involved in a lot of the conflicts in this period, in this area, in different ways. Hopefully you can get a really nice feel. You got the railroad there. But it's, that's Fredericksburg. Really, really nicely done maps. I love the colour palette. It's actually a yellow, very faint, pastely yellow colour, which gives it a really nice feel. And again, I think under plexi, it's going to really pop. So, yeah, looking forward to getting that on the table. So, in summary, you've got three really nice maps. You've got two sheets of counters. You've got player aids, turn tracks, etc. You've got a playbook. You've got rules of play. you got dice, you got baggies, and you've got, I would say, a lovely box of joy. And that's Rebel Fury, Battles of the American Civil War. I may decide to post another video talking a little bit about the mechanics with the game, but I am aware there is, say, lots of information already out there. So I'll be led by the listeners, by the subscribers, by the community on the channel. If you want more information around this game, let me know, and I will pop it on the list to get some more detail out there for you in due course. Just to forewarn you, the channel may go a little bit quiet for a week or so. I've got a short holiday coming up, but hope to bring you some more information, material, and wargaming goodness very, very soon. Thanks for your continued support, and look forward to seeing you all again very, very soon.